Esmeralda, welcome to my YouTube video. I am going to be doing, as you guys can see from the title, this is going to be a review on an audiobook of basically the book of Hearts and Berries from Therese Marie Mailhot. I hope I said that right. And the actual person who narrates or reads it is actually going to be Rainey Fields. I really, really enjoyed this book, to be honest with you. It definitely had a very poetic flow to it that I absolutely loved. This is a memoir of Therese, and Therese is an Indigenous woman, and she did actually come from, I want to say it was Seabird Island from British Columbia, and that was basically where her reservation was and her tribe. And it's just about her basically coming of age and everything that she remembered and going through growing up. Now, her mother was a social worker, also a poet, as well as an activist as well. I think her name was Wazenak. I don't know if I said her name right. Her dad was Ken Mailhot, and he was actually an artist, but he was also an alcoholic. So there was a lot of struggles between Therese, her mother, and her father, which they did. Her mother and father ended up splitting up, and it's just basically her kind of coming to terms with that, as well as dealing with PTSD, which is post-traumatic stress disorder. She's also dealt with bipolar disorder. But really quickly, Therese is actually a writer. She's a journalist. And this is one of the books that she wrote. This book was originally intended to be a fiction book, but as she was, I guess, finishing up or around the ends of her book, there was something that happened when she went to, I believe it was a coffee shop, something at the very end of the book, you guys will know, but something definitely triggered her to come to terms with possibly just making this a memoir, because she realized a lot of the writings are actually about her story. She was just trying to do some fictional characters so people didn't really relate it to her. But she ended up opening up about it and come to terms with her reality and her memories. And she basically made this book to be more of a memoir, actually a memoir, and her biography. And it's just basically about her true life account of her life. So I thought this was really, really well written. I have never read a book like this before. I haven't. Like, I cannot think of a book that flowed the way this one did. Though I did get the audiobook, I am interested in actually getting an actual hard copy of the actual book and reading it myself, because the way that, I mean, it just flowed, it just amazed me. It was kind of like poetry, you know, like her memoir was definitely a very poetic way of writing it, which was very, very different than other memoirs and biographies that I've actually read. But I'm going to show you guys really quickly a little tidbit of the audiobook. I might cut some pieces out just to kind of shorten it up and give you a little bits and pieces more. But anywho, let me just get to it, because right now it's trying to turn on real quick. Not turning on, but I'm trying to log in. So this is actually Heart and Berries by Therese Marie Mailhot. And like I said, Rainey Fields is the one that's going to be reading it. And you guys can see here, there, the first chapter is actually an introduction by Sherman, which he basically talks about Therese and some of her writings and how he got to know her and whatnot. Okay, so I'm going to get this started and just listen up.
I didn't feel compelled to tell any moral tales or ancient ones. I learned how story was always meant to be for Indian women. Immediate and necessary and fearless, like all good lies. My story was maltreated. I was a teenager when I got married. I wanted a safe home. Despair isn't a conduit for love. We ruined each other, and then my mother died. I had to leave the reservation. I had to get my GED. I left my home because welfare made me choose between necessities. I used a check and some cash I saved for a ticket away, and knew I would arrive with a deficit. That's when I started to illustrate my story, and exactly when it became a means of survival.
Now, I'm gonna leave it at that. I probably did more than what I should have. I don't own the rights to this audiobook, you guys. But I just wanted to give you guys a little snippet of it. And basically, the reason for it is because if you guys notice the way it's written, it's just very straight to the point, telling you what she feels. So yes, she did lose her mother. I want to say she had tuberculosis and she died. But Therese, basically, she talks about how she dealt with her passing away. And also, she does talk a lot about her father eventually, and does a little bit more snippets about him and how he's an alcoholic and he's an artist, and just the struggle between his relationship with his kids. And yeah, it's just a very, very raw, I would have to say, her relationship and her life and everything. So it's definitely an insight too, also to indigenous families and as well as tribes and reservations. It gives you a little bit of insight on that, as well as when it comes to race and how Indians are portrayed and whatnot. How do I explain? Like, this is a really good book to get into if you really want to know a little bit more about indigenous people. But I must say, for sure, when it comes to this particular audiobook, it really did resonate in me. Every little bit, it's like it's still echoing in my brain, if that makes any sense. It's just so beautifully written, and I know I keep repeating that, you guys, but it is really, really nice. I think Therese did a good job. She does talk about her own personal struggles. Like I said, she had definitely a bipolar disorder, and just how she actually took initiative and took control of her life and decided to admit herself so that she can get help for it. And just the struggles of that, and having her pregnancies and her husband, and just, she really brings you into her mind, and it makes you understand more about bipolar disorder as well as post-traumatic stress disorder. That was something that I personally had struggled with. I actually saw my mother get run over by a car, and I almost lost her. It was definitely a bloody mess, and it was by a drunk driver, and I was only shoved by the car, but she definitely got thrown into another vehicle, and it was very traumatizing to see something like that. And it definitely changes a lot of your perspective about life. Mentally, it's very difficult to get through that. But I think because I had to be strong for my mom, and just the realization that, oh my gosh, she's alive and it's going to be a struggle. Literally, she took over a year to 2 years just to be back to herself again. It was very, very difficult to see her go through that, and more importantly, just feeling absolutely guilty that I could have at least tried pushing her away or something, and instead it was her who pushed me away. And it was a lot to come to terms with. So when something traumatic happens to you in your life, you may not always understand, you know, that maybe a certain situation wasn't as traumatic at that point, but then eventually you see the repercussions later on. So I think if you have post-traumatic stress disorder, bipolar disorder, this is something you guys can definitely relate to. This book is definitely perfect for that. And the way that it was, that how she put it together, just made so much sense. Now, really quickly before I end this review, because a lot of it I kind of already said, and maybe I said way too much, but she did, at the very end, like I said, she did make a decision to eventually make this book, which should have been, well, would have been a fiction type of book, turned out to be her memoir. And I really appreciate that she actually did that, because it does bring her into her world, into her mind. And maybe you're into memoirs, but you probably haven't actually read a memoir written like this before. I definitely recommend it. If you haven't yet even are into memoirs or anything like that, I still really recommend this book. This is definitely a book that you guys might want to pick up. And yeah, this is just my take on this particular book. I thank so much Emma Watson for choosing this book for the March and April book club. So yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys really did like this review, give it a like. And also remember to subscribe if you want to see more contents like reviews and unboxings, because that's what the channel is about. So until next time, and yeah, toodles!